Well, there's a petition going around at the University of Minnesota Morris calling for a campus-wide search for graves of possible boarding school students. It now has more than 30,000 signatures. And tonight, Chris looks back into what happened there 100 years ago when that school was the site of a Native American boarding school.
Some 70 years before Morris became a state university, in 1887, a Catholic nun started the Morris Indian School with funding from the federal government. Native children recruited from their reservations received uniforms and haircuts, allowed to speak English only. Half the time was spent learning agriculture and domestic work that partially funded the school.
One of the main goals was to assimilate and exterminate the Indian within.
In 1896, the federal government bought the school. Historian Wilbert Ahern writes documents showed parents were lied to about when students could come home. Children died of disease, and the superintendent at the time, William Johnson, was accused of raping two students and having an affair with a staff member. The school closed in 1909, the property given to the state of Minnesota. The university says recent research indicates there could be 2 to 7 children buried on or near the old boarding school campus.
It is
Dylan Young, a Rosebud Sioux tribal member and vice president of the Morris student body, helped pen a petition in the summer urging the university to search.
How can we expect students, especially our indigenous students, to be able to completely focus on education and have that privilege to have a clear mind and focus solely on their studies if their relatives are buried underneath where they're supposed to be going to class?
While records show children died at the school, the university says there is no record indicating where children might have been buried.
None of those maps reference a cemetery, which makes it enormously challenging, and the ground has been significantly disturbed over time.
It's a massive challenge.
It's a big challenge.
Since this interview was shot, Chancellor Erickson tells me the university received new, high-quality maps with important historic information that could aid in the search for potential graves. Any progress, though, depends on further tribal consultation and direction from tribal historic preservation officers to see if there's enough undisturbed ground at the site to even make a search plausible. So lots of work to be done.
To everyone, including me.
We caught back up with Dylan Young today from Morris for an update on any progress from his perspective.
We understood that there are intricacies to something like returning relatives and searching for them that takes time and patience. And we're willing to give all the patience that's needed to those who are working on this important project.
It must be nice to know that your effort, your petition, your energy has created awareness way outside your community.
People care about this and are starting to understand why it's important, which means we are succeeding in our mission and our objective.
There's something else happening too. You see, when the Morris property was deeded to the state, it was under the condition that Native American students go there for free tuition, and that exists today in Morris. Now, the university has announced starting in the fall of 2022, first-year undergraduate students and tribal college transfer students who are citizens of one of the state's 11 federally recognized tribal nations can get free or reduced tuition now at any of the U of M's 5 campuses in the state, Jana.
All right, thanks, Chris. Just real quick, I know that it takes time, and yesterday we thought maybe this will happen in spring or summer, but what is exactly the next step in Morris? How do they figure out where to go?
Well, there's a ton of work to be done, and they have to run a university, and the tribal nation members have to do their job as well, so they're trying to find time to do this exclusively.
Yeah.
They need to confer with tribal nation leaders. They need to get to the geophysical maps.
Okay.
And they got to find out like where to look and how to do it properly. So it takes a lot of time.
And lastly, do you think they'll make the time? Did you get that sense?
Yes, they will certainly make the time.
Okay.
Do they have the evidence? That's the question.
All right. Thanks, Chris.